us into the blue corner from France, it's Hamlawi Yassine.
Two world titles tonight, the MTGP, brand new world titles to be decided. A huge night for France's Hamlawi Yassine. This one, 59 kilos, 5 3-minute rounds, A-class rules. Well, it was France against England for
Hamlawi
Yassine. They're very, very close to upsetting the odds. And the polls for this one.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the red corner, the Pitbull!
He got 57% of the votes in the poll on the website earlier today. You, the fans at home, think will win this super featherweight world MTGP title. Yassine in France, 43% of those votes, so pretty close indeed. Real showmanship from him as he wakes his way to the ring, and Yassine seems unfazed in the blue corner. He's just patiently waiting, and
never get there.
Yeah, I popped home, did the dishes, read a book.
Ladies and gentlemen, this A-class Muay Thai rules belt will be for the minus 59 kilogram Muay Thai Grand Prix world title. This belt will be contested over 5 3-minute rounds. Introducing to you, firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, he comes from France. Please welcome Hamlawi Yassine. And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, he's representing Team 2 Gym in central London. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Jose the Pitbull Villa!
Boxers to the centre. Gentlemen, you had the rules meeting earlier. You understand the rules. It's an A-class Muay Thai fight. Follow my instructions at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. And let's have a clean fight. Good luck. Go to your corners.
Stare down
Judge
the
ready.
Night as well as
Judge, ready.
Entrance
Judge
of the night.
Ready.
Jose Varela. Hamlui Yassin stands between him and that.
Boxers ready, round one, box.
Super featherweight world title.
Round one.
Round one of five for this one.
Yep, world title fight, Muay Thai Grand Prix. Expect fireworks. We saw fireworks in the last world title fight. Two knockdowns in the first round. Still managed to come back and become world champion.
And again, it's a Frenchman trying to upset one of the fighters out of the famous Team Chu gym. Yassin really digging those knees into the midsection.
Stop boxing, break. Step back. Let go. Box.
Side of the fight. Chasing me around, well, that was clever from Varela.
Box.
Jose has his right hand very high up in close. He leaves his liver wide open. He needs to make sure he doesn't take a left body hook or a left knee. His hand's very high. When they get in close, you'll see his hand's very high up. He leaves his ribs wide open. To make sure he doesn't take a body shot or a knee there, it's going to hurt.
Getting tangled up on the ropes on our near side here. Nice low kick there from Varela. Wasted a little time, didn't
they? Yeah, absolutely.
Time.
The first round, both fighters.
Particular stylistic features that French fighters bring that the viewers at home might be able to pick up on, anything you can remember from your career?
Yeah, I fought many French fighters, and savate is the French national sport, French foot fighting it's called, but they usually go into a full contact kickboxing background, which is slightly different to K1, where kicks are only allowed above the waist, and I have a world title in that as well as K1. The French are very, very dangerous. Some amazing French fighters. Some of the best fighters I've ever fought were French.
Let's
the best
go,
female fighter at around 60 kilo on the planet, I believe, is currently French, Anissa Mexen. So they're certainly dangerous.
Okay, round two. Box.
Hamlui Yassin looking to add to that French heritage. This world title just narrowly avoids that high kick from Varela. The inside of the groin there for him too. Strong start for the Frenchman. Solid contact. there from Varela. And he moves away now. Ooh, what a good counter right hand. That sent Yassim right the way back onto his heels. See King to show the judges that he's dominant in the clinch now.
Okay, stop boxing, break. Let go. Step back. Let go. Box.
Still feels the Frenchman is coming forward and forcing the fight more. He's a bit scrappy and not particularly effective at times. He's still the one.
Yeah, he's the one coming forward, and as you say, in the process, he has walked onto one or two counters, especially with the right hand, but you have to feel that he's the one pressing the action.
Yep.
Whether the judges will forego that as a result. On the back of the head of Yassim really slammed down hard onto the canvas there. Seems to be okay. But
time front kick there.
Box.
Pouncing on him straight away. That's good from the Frenchman. Comes in with an elbow. Morena spinning him around, throwing an elbow of his own. Again, like for like exchanges.
Box.
Slip, I think.
Box.
Front kick from Varela, then a right hand on the back of it. And the referee doing a good job of staying out of the way of that kick too.
Yeah, certainly tricky fellow to catch, Sean.
Oh, tough job they've got in there, staying close enough to the action that they can see what's going on, but far enough away to avoid some pretty fast moving limbs as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Probably have the best distancing and range in the entire event. Yeah.
Jose Varela there in the red corner. The advice room. His man there. You see, he's taking that in. Focus, young man. Despite the theatrics at the beginning, make no mistake, this man means business. Make of the inside clinches there, Andrew, anything in particular?
Yeah, they're constantly jostling position.
Seconds.
They're both managing to dig their knees in, both trying the elbows. No one's been too successful as of yet.
Seconds out.
French fighters certainly Boston pushing three. The action.
Let's
just a little bit
seconds away.
A little bit sporadic.
Lil.
Not as, a little bit as wild. Effective aggression as it could be, perhaps.
Okay, round three. Box.
There we go, round three of five. Varela waiting patiently, catches the lead leg, throws a hard right on it, but just quite find the target. And in comes Yassim with a high jumping knee. The referee working those ropes to keep the men in that designated area. And again, next scene, dumped to the canvas.
Break. Box.
Seems to get insulted when he gets dumped to the canvas, the Frenchman. He gets angry. Some charge forward.
Thumping kick there. Sent him off balance. Again,
box.
Rushing into the ropes. On commentary desk. Low kick again from Varela. It's been a good spell in the last minute or so. Still 1:50 to go in this third round. He's just made Yassim lose his balance on a number of occasions and shown real dominance past the midpoint of round number three.
Stop boxing, break. Step back. Let go. Step back. Box.
As you say, there's a certain amount of anger and fire about the Frenchman too.
Yeah, absolutely. Straight right hand to the belly might hurt him a bit, but no, he's back in action. A little bit less physical strength, perhaps, the Frenchman. That's why he's getting thrown around the clinch, but certainly makes up for that in his game to fight.
Okay, let go. Much. Break. Let go.
A little bit messy on the ropes.
Let go.
Yeah.
Let go. Step back. Box.
Bit of slide cut above the eye of Varela, the right eye. Persistent dig into the body and two exchanging knees, and Yassin perhaps hurt a little bit in that exchange.
Yeah, he backed up a little bit there, taking that knee.
Up, up, up. Break. Box.
In there, then a knee from Varela, and he's just starting to find his feet here. Pardon the punt.
Stop boxing, break. Let go. Wait. Step back. Box. Time.
A better round for Jose Varela. Yassin made sure the frustration doesn't start to creep into his performance when it was going pretty well in the early couple of rounds.
Yeah, I mean, he's always been a bit wild, a bit sporadic, but now he's starting to charge forward a bit haphazardly now. He's getting a bit frustrated. So if he calms down a little bit, stays effective. Doesn't look tired. Looks like he has enough left in the tank. Two rounds to go.
Any particular methods you used to use to regain your composure, or sort of hit the reset button if you got frustrated at any points in time? And there must have been times where you got frustrated and, you know, had to then regain your composure.
Anything yeah, absolutely. I fought in China against a 6'9".
10 seconds.
Seconds
Chinaman. I didn't know they grew that big.
Boxing is ready.
It was very, very frustrating because it's hard to hit. But, you know, you just have to stay calm, stay composed, and do what works. And sometimes against certain opponents, only one or two things work, but you've got to stick to them.
And Yassin find that composure that he showed in the opening couple of rounds. Can Varela continue the pressure that he started to exert in the third? Yet another world title fight, pretty finely poised here at the O2 Arena in London. The inaugural Muay Thai GP series. Fantastic evening's action, and this the penultimate matchup.
Stop boxing, break. Box.
See, coming straight forward again, crashing in. Roundhouse to the body, then another one. This time to the right. Hand side of the ribs of Varela.
Break!
Varela showing good dominance in the clinch.
Wait!
There. And Yassin certainly is Box. Showing signs of frustration. More and more as it progresses. Off balance again there.
Box.
Yeah, he's falling down a lot as well. He's not as physically strong in the clinch, I believe. He can get pushed around a little bit.
Nice front kick there. Just momentarily stopped Varela in his tracks. Came together there. Yassin. No cuts though, which is good.
Break! Break, break. Stop boxing. Stop boxing when I say. Break when I say.
Well, the ropes Box. Have been really stretched to their full capacity in this one.
They certainly have. They've saved us a few times. Barely. Once again, thrown down.
Box.
Yassin really, really wants to go straight back to work. And the referee had a hard job to keep them broken up. And knees there to the midsection from Yassin.
Is this going to end with Yassin on the floor again? Thrown down again, perhaps.
Varela looking for it, isn't he?
Nearly.
Bang Miner, right hook into the body. Yassine comes back. A bit of early confetti here.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Not sure what the celebration is.
They're celebrating our fantastic commentary, of course.
I don't think they are.
Box!
Well, maybe they are. You're welcome. What a slow kick from Yassine. Nearly made Varela lose his balance, but Varela now, he's caught that front leg. And again, dominance in the clinch. Knees are on the way down.
Box!
Be careful of that. Oh, and a spinning back elbow. Yassine comes back, and it really is spirited performance in the Frenchman.
Yeah, he keeps marching forward. He's marching. He's not doing anything that effectively. He won't stop coming.
The boxing break.
Oh, fire in the French camp, that's for sure. So, one more round. It's an ultimate fight of the night. And the main
last
event,
round,
the
yeah.
final
keep
four
clean,
tournament
please.
To come, and a big, big night. Big implications. For now, one round separates Jose Varela, red gloves, and Luis Yassine from becoming new super featherweight world champion in Muay Thai Grand Prix Series here at the O2 Arena in London. It's been a terrific night so far. Some of the highlights there from round four.
Seconds away.
Yes, heads coming together as
seconds
they go
out.
Into the clinch.
Boxers ready. Let's go. Red corner, let's go. Okay, last round. Box.
Fifth and final round.
Back to the ropes, trying to block that low kick. Yassine switching southpaw. Left hand to the body, right hand over the top. Well, the other way around. It's good work from Yassine in the clinch. Good blood from the nose of Varela too.
Break! Break! Stand up. Stand up. Turn around. Wait, wait, listen. Okay. Don't take him over the hip, okay? Listen.
Boy,
listen.
Is really,
don't take him over the hip.
Really frustrating.
Okay. Box.
Yeah, certainly is. The referee having to work hard. He comes forward, flashes in that low kick, right hook, kicks Varela low again. And, well, this is pure anger and frustration from the Frenchman. It's fueling his performance. It might be what he needs. Who knows?
Break.
We'll find out.
Let go.
We'll get the decision.
Box.
Knockout if it comes.
Break. Let go. Box.
Ooh, just slipped the elbow.
Break.
Let go. He's exhausted, but he just will not stop coming.
Box.
No, he certainly won't stop going for it. He is forcing the action big time.
Yeah,
so Varela looking at him, show of defiance, and I think it's angering him more, wanting to make him throw more. Seen leaning all over him in the clinch, digging those knees
break.
Into the hip, and elbow into the face
box.
There too. March forward he does, and then he drops Varela.
Turn around. Box!
Referee getting involved. Here's the three-man fight.
It is, yeah. Triple threat in there. Goodness gracious me. 54 seconds to go. And this last round is, well, say mean-spirited, but certainly
let go.
The fieriest of rounds that we've seen.
Break! Box!
It's again tied up in the clinch. I think he's just got the red mist, the French fighter. He doesn't have any clue what's going on yet or anymore. He's just fighting until the fight is over.
He is fighting on instinct. He's making it difficult for Varela. He throws him down again, turns him around. He's got dominance in the clinch there, chucks an elbow in. Yassine responds with a knee. Whoa, ducks underneath the spinning elbow.
Stop boxing,
from
mate.
Varela. The referee.
Above. 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 When I say break, break. Let's go, box. Time. Finished.
Okay. Well, an unorthodox ending to the five rounds there.
Very unorthodox.
But Sean Boland had to keep pushing him away. He had to keep pushing him because he wasn't doing as he was told, and he had to keep pushing him to get the space. So, you know, at the end he fell down, but he should be listening to the referee in the first place, really. Five or six times he needed to be physically pushed away from his opponent.
The two men eventually smile and hug. So good to see, because it was getting bad tempered at points. We'll go to the judges' scorecards. Some work rate from Yassine, regardless of a few of the misgivings.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we get a massive round of applause for both of these men after five hard-fought championship rounds? And after those five rounds, your judges have reached a split decision in favour of your winner and the new minus 59 kilogram MTGP world champion. Fighting out of the red corner is Jose the Pitbull Barrera. Show your appreciation for our runner-up, Pamela.
Well, that's hard fought as a victory gets, and for Jose Barrera, he walks home as the new super featherweight MTGP world champion. Many congratulations to him. I'm sure we'll hear a few words from him in just a moment's time.
Jose, come here. I'll tell you what, you had a top team in the opposite corner, but you come from a very good stable yourself. That was a very hard fight. I'll be honest, at the end of that fight, I saw it in clips, I wasn't sure who won that. That was very, very close. You just did a little bit more. What have you got to say to all these people out here who come to support you?
What else I can say? They say it for me, look. What else I can say? They already said it for me. Like I always say, I come to put a show, you know, or you kill me, or you see me for five rounds. And that motherfucker was hard. He was hard. Even me, I'm confused because I thought he had it, but I just, anytime I come to the corner, my coach used to tell me, you got this game plan, stick to the game plan, go in knee, because the knee scores more. So that's what I was thinking, but I won't be able to walk tomorrow. I need the crunches. Motherfucker.
In your best English.
Aye, this is my best English right now, man. Paramedics, you got work to do. Come take me upstairs. Hey, like I said, man, first of all, I want to thank everybody, every single one of you for being here. Now, You guys, the reason this show is still standing and still the best show in UK so far. I want to thank the promoters, Phil, Simon, Kieran, for having me here. I want to thank Phil for putting the hard work on me. That's why I stand here for five rounds, because training is like mental. But listen, I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. Also, I want to thank my fitness coach, Flavia, João, they worked me hard. I hate them, but I love them now. Woo! Party time! The bar is open for 5 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the brightest and most talented people and the most entertaining in the sport. One more time, please. Jose Varela!